Assalamu alaikum, my name is Muktaki from an Aftahi. I reading class 4. I am a student of Oxbridge English School. Today I will tell you all an interesting story. The story name is, I cannot tell you because it's so fun here. Okay, so let's begin. Once upon a time, there lived a little girl which always wore a little red riding hood. So everyone used to call her Little Red Riding Hood. Her mom, "Darling, Little Red Riding Hood." "Yes, mommy." Her mom, "You know your grandma is ill, so I have prepared for her some fresh cookies and herbs. Can you take this for her?" "Yes, of course, mommy, I will. So I have drawn something for your example. I am seeing you. You can see it is her mother, and here's the basket full of cookies and herbs. And you can see here the Red Riding Hood. It is the Red Riding Hood. And you can see all the beautiful skies and plants also." When she was leaving her mom, "Do not leave the path of Bunny Forest," Little Red Riding Hood was sleeping. And she started her journey by walking, singing. Then she go to Little Red Riding Hood. "I am going in the path of Bunny Forest. So why I have not seen any bunnies among here?" Then she come to a place filled with flowers. I have also, for examples, I also draw. You can see here. Here is Little Red Riding Hood, and here is the path of where flowers was filled with, and here is the tree and also from flowers, and here is the and the beach. You can see here a tree also, and Little Red Riding Hood was seen in the flowers. "Little Red Riding Hood, I will pick some flowers for my grandmother. My grandmother will be very pleased." When she was picking flowers, she heard a sound from her. Suddenly she heard a sound from the bushes. Suddenly a big bad wolf approached her at second. You can see there, I also draw. You can see here the tea. Here Little Red Riding Hood was bit afraid and dropped the basket. You can see drop the basket, and here is also flowers. And here's the big bad wolf. You can see here. Here is the big bad wolf. It's so spooky, and it is saying, "Little Red Riding Hood was afraid. The wolf picked the cookies and herbs which is fouled by her hand. The wolf gave it to Little Red Riding Hood." The Little Red Riding Hood was amazed by his unexpected texture. "Little Red Riding Hood, thank you." The wolf, "Where are you going, little girl?" Little Red Riding Hood, "I'm going to my grandmother's house. She's very ill." The yellow house is over below of the forest. "I go first and tell your," the wolf, "I go first and tell your grandmother that you are coming. That you are coming." Finally, a shotgun scream, and the wolf was afraid, and he ran from there as fast as he can possible. Little Red Riding Hood looked around and around, and saw a tree, and she sat there, and start crying. Then, by hearing her crying, a hunter came to him. The hunter, "Why are you crying, little girl? Why are you here? This place is very dangerous." Little Red Riding Hood was ashamed that she would not Lisa and her mothers do not leave the path of Bunny Forest, and she will not tell that she meet the Big Bad Wolf. Little Red Riding Hood. I lost here. I was going to my grandmother's house. She is very ill. The hunter. I will take you to your grandmother's house. Then this two start journey to the grandmother's house. But the big bad wolf reached there and knocked the door. The grandma yoked from himself. Who is it? The big bad wolf changed his voice. The wolf said, "It's me, Grandma, Little Red Riding Hood." The grandma again joked from himself. "Oh, you can come in, my dear. The door is open. The door is open." The fox tracked into the house. And after a while, Little Red Riding Hood and the hunter come. The hunter, go to your grandma if you don't face any problems. The Little Red Riding Hood, okay. Little Red Riding Hood knocked the door. The wolf again changed his voice and yoked from inside. The wolf, who is it? It's me, Grandma, Little Red Riding Hood. The wolf again yoked from inside. You can come in, my dear. The door is open. Door is open. So Little Red Riding Hood coming to the house, and she was weird that his grandmother had a different sound. But she know that her grandmother is ill. Then she go to inside. After going inside, there was darkness. She would not recognize her grandmother because of the darkness. The wolf, all the light in the darkness, of the light, all the darkness. So she could not recognize the wolf. The wolf was also disliked Grandma by wearing his glasses, nightcap, and night dress, and laying on the bed. And the wolf, I think you have precious problem coming to me. Little Red Riding Hood, come in. I can hug you better. Little Red Riding Hood come closer and closer. He could not recognize, but he sees so little, and it not recognize because there was so many of the darkness. And he left the basket here, and she was going to the gun. Then she stopped there and said, "Why are your hands so huge?" "So that I can hug you better," the wolf said. Little Red Riding Hood, "Why are your ears so huge?" The wolf, "So that I can hear you better." Why are your eyes so huge?" The wolf, "So that I can see you better." "Why are your teeth so sharp, Grandma?" The wolf, "So that I can eat you better." Then she jumped from the bed and came into the floor. Little Red Riding Hood screamed, "Help! Help!" Then the hunter heard her scream and go straight into the house and shit and take the gun and hit with it. The wolf was painted and goes fine. The hunter, "Now I got you, you big bad wolf. Now you in my hand." You can see, I don't see you the picture of when she jumped. You see here, when she jumped, you can see the wolf. Yeah. Nightcap, glasses, and night dress. And here also, Little Red Riding Hood was afraid. You can see. So the hunter, "You in my hand." The hunter also rescued grandmother. Little Red Riding He also saved Little Red Riding Hood. Little Red Riding Hood, thank you for saving us, Mr. Hunter. Little Red Riding Hood, you're welcome. But promise me that you will not forward your mother words again. Little Red Riding Hood, yes, I will. Okay. Then Grandma and Little Red Riding Hood eat all the cookies and herbs to make it healthy habit. They also take a cup of tea which her mother has boxed for us. They take teas, cookies and herbs. And then when she was going, her grandma says, you know, you can promise me that you will not again fall in the words of Big Bad Wolf. Little Red Riding Hood, okay grandma, I promise. Then she was started her journey by walking, singing. After that, she seed again the wolf. She was cleaning the forest with the mop. And then the wolf punished by the hunter. The wolf shame what he do with Little Red Riding Hood. And she again joining, walking and happiness. Again go to the bunny forest, and the bunny forest is full of bunnies. Beautiful, beautiful colors of trees and butterflies. Okay, it's the end of the Little Red Riding Hood story. Okay, bye my friends and honorable teachers, if you like it. Okay, thank you.